Hi, my name is Lijesh. I work with Cisco Tech. I have been with Cisco for more than 4.5 years. In this video, I'm going to help you understand more about DS3 SM-X-T3 E3 module in ISR-G2 router platforms. This is a friend view of this card. You can see DS3 port where you normally connect coaxial cable, TX and RX. This is the motherboard of the card. Unlike any other DS3 legacy T33 module like NM-T3E3, SMX has its dedicated CPU, memory, and most importantly, it runs on Linux operating system. This is the hardware architecture of this particular card. You can see SMX, backplane, and the host. So all the communication between SM and the host happens via emulated Ethernet SM interface. So whenever the module is powered on, three main things happens normally. SM sends a boot P request to the host. Host responds back with DHCP lease. SM download the firmware from the host. Operating system is loaded and the DS3 interface is initialized. So now let me take you through some of the useful CLIs. So you can see SMX card is on slot 1. So show IP interface brief, include SM. Will tell you the SM interface. So you can see IP address 192.168.2.1. So there is a logic behind the subnet calculation. So let me take you through that. So the logic behind the subnet calculation is 192.168.1 plus the slot number. So here in our case, the slot number is 1. So 1 plus the slot number, that is 2. So the IP subnet is 192.168.2.1. So SM interface are assigned with an IP address through DHCP via an internal VRF, which I'll show you right now. So show IP VRF will show you the internal VRF. So show IP root VRF and the VRF name will give you the root. So this was a subnet which we are talking sometime back. Okay, now let me brief you about the most important configuration which must be enabled in the router if you have SM-X-T3E3 module. So you must enable service DHCP command globally because SM interface gets an IP address via DHCP. So let me show you. So you can see I have disabled service DHCP command over here. So if you have SM-X-T3E3 module, you must enable service DHCP command. So show IP DHCP binding assign. So now let me go to config T service DHCP. I have now enabled service DHCP command. Now let me show you the output of show IP DHCP command. As you can see, this particular IP address is under the VRF. So I've seen many tag cases, customer missed to enable this service DHCP command. So they think that the DS3 module is faulty and they normally raise a tag case for RMA. So there were cases, some of the customer has raised more than 2-3 RMAs for the same module. So looking at the screen, now you can see that SMX module has come up. So you have to keep in mind, once you enable the service DHCP command, make sure you see this particular message. So this message indicates that the communication between the SM and the host is fine. Now let me take you through some of the troubleshooting steps which you can perform. So here you can see I've applied this command hardware module SM1 OIR stop. So this means that if you really want to do a OIR, you can perform this particular command. So you can remove the hardware from the box. So you can see SM interface has went down. Before activating the card, let me check whether the service DHCP is enabled or not. You can see now I have configured no service DHCP just to show you. So now let me activate this card. You can activate this card with start. Now you see that SM interface has come up. Show IP interface brief, include SM. You can see SM has got an IP address. these are the logs which is expected. You can see now seal and bridge down. Show IPVRF. So you can now see, let me check, show IP route VRF. These are the subnets. Show IP DHCP binding assigned. Before enabling this command, I want to show you the interface status. Show IP interface brief. So interface status, it's down right now. We have the SM interface which is up right now. Let me show you the controller status. Show controller serial 1/0. Now you can see the controller status, the card, the firmware version, etc. I want you to keep this in mind. Let me now enable the service DHCP command, service DHCP. One thing you have to keep in mind is once you apply the service DHCP command, the module takes some time to come up. Let me show you that. Show IP DHCP binding assigned. Now we got an IP address. It's under internal VRF. You can see now this message. This indicates that the communication between the SM and the host is up. Now let me show you the output of controller series 0. You can now see all this FPGA information. It will show you the full outputs and some of the things to keep in mind. Make sure you enable service DHCP command globally and never shut down SM interface. Make sure your card is detected in show inventory or show DIAC. So before winding up the session, let me take you through one of the known bug. The bug ID is 32889, which talks about if you enable IP DHCP bootp ignore command in your router, the module won't come up. To make this work, you have to give no IP DHCP bootp ignore command, or you have to upgrade the iOS, which is mentioned in this particular bug. I hope this has been informative. Thanks for watching.